We would now like to make a short presentation about a particular policy which we believe could be significantly culture-changing, and I'd like to invite Lord Saatchi, our chairman, to come up to the stage and discuss it. While he's making his way here, 70 years ago, Mrs. Thatcher's favorite intellectual, Friedrich von Hayek, published The Road to Serfdom. We now propose The Road from Serfdom. But before Morris starts, one quotation from Hayek: our freedom of choice in a competitive society rests on the fact that if one person refuses to satisfy our wishes, we can turn to another. But if we face a monopolist, we are at his absolute mercy. Morris.
Okay, let's go. This is a door. This door looked like that 18 months ago. And this is the same door as it looked last month. This door is on the Gatwick Express. We thought at the Centre for Policy Studies this door is not appropriate and that somebody should clean it up. Not the sort of thing you want visitors to England to see. So this is easy enough. We spoke to the manager in the Gatwick Express, who explained that the Gatwick Express is a subsidiary of Southern Trains. Fine. So we spoke to Southern Trains managers, and they explained that Southern Trains is a division of Govia, a partner company of Keolis. Fine. Speak to Govia. We found out that Govia is a division of Go Ahead Group. So but this, fine. We said, okay, what we'll do is this time we're going to go right to the top. We're going to go to the chairman. We'll explain this door to the chairman. He'll understand. He'll see the importance of not having doors like this. So we found the chairman, but we found that he owned 0.001% of the equity of Go Ahead Group. So we said, all right, fine, not him. What we want here is the owner. We've got to speak to the owner. The owner's going to look at this door and the owner's going to say, we can't have doors like this. And the owner will do something about it. So we found the owner. The owner is the Vanguard Group, Malvern, Pennsylvania. So we said, no, not that owner. We want the real owner who will really look at this door and will really see this is not the sort of door. We finally found the real owner. UBS AG Wealth Management Division, Zurich. At which point we said, here is the door. Keep your door. This door is not what Mrs. Thatcher intended. This door is not in accordance with her wishes. How do I know that? Because I asked her. I asked her, what is the share of the top five banks in all financial transactions in the UK? Credit cards, loans, overdrafts, mortgages, everything. She said she didn't know. I said, it's 80%. She said, with eyes blazing, impossible. I said, it's not impossible, it's a fact. By impossible, Mrs. Thatcher did not mean it's not true. What she meant was, it's intolerable. And of course, as usual, she was right. Her version of what she meant when creating the Centre for Policy Studies to put forward her ideas about free markets, free market capitalism, etc. What her version of what we were doing probably was best expressed by Professor Lionel Robbins at LSE. This is coming up in a minute. He said as follows, that what competition means is I'll quote him exactly. Every day, hundreds of people cast their votes for the thousands of products and services on offer. And from the competition to win their votes, better and better products and services emerge. That is indeed the essence of competition and therefore the essence of capitalism. But it's not quite how it's turned out, as you can see from what's been on the screen, in terms of market shares of the top five companies in Britain in various categories. So the result of this not quite turning out what was intended is that the jury of public opinion in Britain, which you all know is the most sophisticated jury in the world, has formed a view. And now I'm going to show you the result of a CPS poll, which we commissioned ourselves, to find out what people have got to say about big government and big companies. And you will see from here that we asked them whether they trusted big government and whether they trusted big companies. And you can see from the figures that 70% of the British people distrust big government. Well, that's no surprise to us. But on the other hand, virtually the same number distrust big companies. Why would this be? Because they may have worked out that competition, as in that quote from Professor Robbins, is the reason why capitalism works. Take it away and you remove the keystone of the arch, the base of the pyramid. You are left only with the unintended consequence, apparently, of globalization, which is called cartelization. The creation of global cartels in which there is a huge imbalance of power between the individual customer and the giant corporation. A sense of powerlessness and unfairness, two words in which I'm quoting one of the great figures at the Bank of England. Powerlessness and unfairness that results from a world of global corporations whose governance, maybe taxes, are beyond the reach of national governments. This is an unhappy outcome, that poll, which we can take off the screen now. This is an unhappy outcome for all believers in free market capitalism. And I must tell you, nobody is more upset about that poll than we are at the Centre for Policy Studies. So, after all, this is what this organisation was created to promote. So it's most upsetting. So we decided to do something about it. We don't want dependence on either big government or big companies. We want freedom from both. So we want to achieve a social change, a culture change, which we're going to certainly claim now will be as big as Mrs. Thatcher's own your own home, sale of council houses to their tenants, which certainly won three elections for the Conservative Party in a row and did change the culture. In a few words, what we want is that people will be the master of their own destiny. That's what we want. And that's why the CPS is publishing today, as Tim Knox just said, The Road from Serfdom. This is a policy statement now in the hands of the Treasury, and I'm sure this evening we'll hear from the Chancellor what his response is. In this policy, which is it's available now, and you can see, you'll have to stand by for this. Corporation tax is abolished for small companies. Capital gains tax is abolished for investors in small companies. Remember, an extraordinary fact this, the average UK company has 5 employees. Small companies, as defined in the tax law, those are companies with less than 50 employees, are known as small companies. These small companies account for half of all UK non-government employment. The policy will abolish corporation tax, therefore, for 90% of UK companies. It will, according to the maths of the great geniuses at the Centre for Policy Studies, it will, we claim today, reduce the deficit faster than predicted by the Office of Budget Responsibility, expand employment faster than predicted by the OBR, increase competition, challenge cartel capitalism, and let millions of people grow tall. These millions of individuals will enjoy the opportunity to say, I am the captain of my ship. They will enjoy more money and take the first step on the road from serfdom. The nation as a whole will benefit from a change in culture as big, as I said, as own your own home in the 1980s. Greater economic growth and lower unemployment than forecast by the OBR, more competitive marketplaces, and more freedom and independence from both big government and big companies. Our aim at the Centre for Policy Studies, and it's wonderful to see you all here supporting this aim and to have heard some of the remarkable speeches that have been made. Our aim, as we all know, is freedom. But here's the point. In the real world, the world we all live in, money and freedom are connected. To deny that is hypocrisy. Because, as Professor J.K. Galbraith said, the greatest restriction on the liberty of the citizen is a complete absence of money. 40 years ago, when she founded the Centre for Policy Studies, Mrs. Thatcher explained how to resolve that. She said, as you all know, if you want a bigger cake, if you want a bigger slice of cake, the best thing to do is bake a bigger cake. Then everyone gets a bigger slice. To bake a bigger cake, we are saying today, the tax system is the great underutilized weapon of our time. This policy shows how the awesome power of taxation can be used to the benefit of everyone. How will it work? How do the maths work? What are the principles behind it? I think Bertrand Russell said, didn't he, that simplicity is not the outcome, is the outcome of technical subtlety. It is the goal, not the starting point. Therefore, we are now going to attempt to summarize a 400-page policy proposal in 3 minutes.
Tell old Pharaoh to let my people
Thank you. It's now time to go and have lunch. If we could just wait for Maurice, he's got to rush off to do a Google Hangout to promote this around the world. But thank you, and we'll see you in an hour's time. Have a good lunch.